this whole campaign been harder than you've expected? I mean, I know you said you came into this with your eyes open, but has it been tougher than you expected?
I didn't expect media will be so dishonest and so mean. I didn't expect that. Also for me, from the beginning, I never had one correct story, one honest story. From New York Post, 2 days in a row, they put me on the cover with the pictures that I did many, many years ago as a model. I'm very proud I did those pictures. I'm not ashamed of my body. I feel very comfortable with myself and with my body. And they were taken for European French magazine. And in Europe, we are proud of bodies, no matter what size you are. And it was done as an art, as a celebration of female body. So they put it twice in a row. In that story, they put the date when pictures were taken wrong. They never called me when the pictures were taken.
Right, there were allegations that
I was here.
It was much earlier than you were actually here.
Correct. And suddenly it becomes, I'm here illegally, I was married before. I said, like, yeah, find me the husband that I was married before my husband. There were a lot of, a lot of dishonest stuff. And that surprised me, that they will not check the facts and that reporters will just write. And surprised me also because every story, it's a female. It's a female reporter. And that's why when they went too far in on the website, one of the websites and newspapers, and the blogger as well, I said, this is it. I will fight for myself, I will fight for my name. They cannot damage my name and my reputation because it's not true. And the names that they're calling me, they're calling my husband, they're calling my family, it's unacceptable.
In defending himself, and your husband has again categorically said these allegations are all false.
Yes.
He's made some comments about the way some of the women who are accusing him look. What do you think about that?
Well, that's him. He's raw. He will say it as he feels it. So, I know he respects women, but he's defending his because they are lies.
You have a young son.
Yes.
Is he aware of all this? Is that a conversation you have to have with your son?
I let him have a normal childhood as possible. We talk a lot about the campaign. We talk about the language because I don't allow that he uses bad language. He's in that age and all the boys are in that age. That, yeah, they say some bad words and it's very normal, they're growing up. But I tell him that, you know, there are consequences as well, and he needs to be careful the language he uses. I teach him, I tell him, that's why it was my decision not to be on the campaign trail. I don't listen to anybody about what to do, what to say, when to say it, when to do interviews. If it will be, for example, for my husband or the campaign, they will have me on the trail all the time. They wish to have me there. But I made the decision. I will be a parent to our boy, to our child.
Your husband said last week that you two are stronger today than you ever were before. Do you feel that way?
We always have a great marriage and strong relationship. And he said many times, you know, that I'm a rock for a whole family. And we are very strong. We are two independent people thinking on their own and have a very open conversation. And I think that's very healthy for the relationship.
The other thing that's being talked a lot about on the campaign trail, that your husband is saying he believes the election is rigged, that there's a lot of forces trying to rig it. Do you feel that as well?
Well, I see it how the media is portraying. I see how they're reporting and what they want to say and what they don't want to say. They going, just for example, he makes a speech 45 minutes long. They take a sentence out and they going on and on and on about that sentence. Nothing else. And he talks about the issues, and that's what American people want to hear. It's about issues, about jobs, about the future of our country. And that's what he wants to do. He wants to secure the borders. He wants to secure America. He wants to bring jobs back. He wants to bring economy back. And he's very passionate about American people because he knows he can do that. He's a worker. He's a fighter. He's very passionate about it. And he will not give up. He will fight till the end. And he will fight for American people as he's fighting now for himself.
You have one more debate coming up. Do you get nervous?
No.
You don't?
No. No. I always said to him, be you, be yourself, be calm, be focused, stay on the issues, because American people, they want to hear what you will do for them. Because we discussed many times at home, and I know what is in his mind, and the way he can lead that country.
We're 3 weeks to the election. If you could let the American people know one thing about your husband, what would it be? Because right now, the latest polls show, I think more than 60% of people believe your husband made some sort of unwanted advances. What do you want those people to know? What would you say to them? Well, we'll have her answer to that question coming up, and the panel reaction as well.